at you with another one. What we're gonna do here is a bald fade with the beard. I'm gonna take my 3-0 and I'm just gonna bald out. He wants like a medium fade, not too high and not too low. So, creating that bowl, even all around. Now I'm using a 3 first because it's gonna give it that, that blend when I come back with the 5-0. Go to that 5-0 and just bald it out some more. But I'm not gonna go, as you can see, I don't wanna go all the way up and create another line. I'm just going like half an inch under that first line. And you're gonna see the difference. But when you start fading, then you're gonna see. You're gonna see the difference. Then you're not stuck trying to just get out of line, get out that bowl. It's gonna just make it easier. So I still use the 76ers, man. You know, when I'm balling out, a lot of barbers I see today use the, they balled out with the, just go straight to the edger. Nothing's wrong with that. I have many different techniques, but right here, I'm going with my Andes cordless. I'm just opening it up back and forth. I close it and open it using my corners. I like to use the corners because it thins out the hair, thins out certain parts. Open again. Now I'm just going to create that second line. Have the clippers open. Now I'm going to take that one. I'm just going to rake at it. Rake at it, give it a smooth blend. Open, all in the wrist. Just wanna flick it, flick that line out, flick it out. It's all in technique. Like everything is in steps. You wanna always make sure that you do the same thing for each type of haircut. You don't wanna just cut to try to make it look good. You wanna do it in steps and routine. I feel it's best that way. So you're not in the middle of a haircut just trying to make it look good and everything's all uneven. You wanna do everything in steps. Now I'm closing it to get that line out a little bit more. Going to my 2, a little bit bigger. I'm just smoothing it out. And you see it's a little bit darker back there, so I'm just, same technique, flick it out. See, I wanna rake it, not straight up. Just rake at it, flick it out. If I just keep going straight up, I'm just gonna create more of a problem for myself and have to fade it higher and higher, and that's not what the customer's looking for. So now I'm closing it. I'm gonna bald it out in levels, usually about 2 to 3 levels when you're coming to fade out the bottom line. As you see, it's just slowly disappearing. As I go up, I just want to open it more. Open it some more. Now I'm using that corner again. thinning it out. Just want to keep thinning it out. Don't get impatient. You know, sometimes people want to just rush through it. The mirror never lies, so you always want to use your mirror so you can see what you missed, or if the lines are straight or if they're crooked. Now I'm just lining his the top of his beard up. He wants to bring it up a little bit more, so we're just going to create a higher line and end up blending it. As you can see, these gold FX by Babeliss, I like these things. Got a lot of power in them for an edger. So right here, I'm just gonna just line everything. Out right here a little bit, cleaning up the back. Edge that bottom. Just clean them up. Now, I just want to finish them off with, after I've done the line, put that razor on there. You pull out that razor, customers get excited. I'm like, oh, I'm getting that real, getting that work today. Sometimes, you know, pulling out that razor, they're going to tip you good, they're going to pay you good, and they're going to know that, you know, you took care of them that day. You always want to try to give extra services when you can. In fact, just make it a part of your package of what you're offering the customer. You don't want them to go somewhere and not leave.